Hi everybody, my name is Kat and I am the head of education for Bellamy Hair. Now right here on these racks, I have got every single color that Bellamy has to offer in all of our different clip-ins. And what we're going to do is we're going to break down every single one of them so you can really get an idea of which color is going to work best for you. Now the first color range that we are going to break down is going to be our naturals. Now naturals include colors that are going to be the same from top to bottom. Now even inside of one of your natural tones, you will see that there is a little bit of multi-dimensional color and tonality. That way it gives you the option to be able to use this color and still have it blend really nicely with your natural hair, even if it's not a spot on match. So the first color that we are going to go over is going to be our jet black. Now when you're thinking about colors, we always think about what the level is going to be. So this is kind of like a professional idea. What's your level and what's your tone? And your level describes how dark or how light your hair is. And it ranges from a 1 up to a 10, even a 12 sometimes when you get into those white platinum colors. Finally, the additional part that we kind of talk about is going to be the tone. Now, you can have a dark brown, but what's the tone of that dark brown? Is it a golden tone? Is it a red tone? And that's really speaking to the undertone of what that color is. So, with our jet black hair, this is going to be the darkest color that we offer, and this is going to be considered a level 1. So this is basically pitch black. This is if you color your hair to a black color. If you walk out into the sunlight, there's no reflection of any brown tone in your hair whatsoever. Jet black is going to be for you. Now, everybody might think, oh, my hair's super dark, it's really, really dark, it's black. It most likely isn't. It's probably something more along the lines of our off black or 1B. So this is going to be a couple of levels lighter than your jet black. So this is probably around a level 1. This one is probably closer to around a level 3. And this is where a lot of dark hair sits naturally. Now your off black has a very natural tone to it. It's almost a neutral, so it's got a little bit of a golden tone to it. So when you take it out into the light, you'll see just a little bit of a lighter brown reflection. Our next color is our 1C Mochaccino. This is going to be around a level 5 on the color spectrum with golden tones as its undertone. And you'll be able to see in this color, once you kind of piece it apart, you've got a couple of dark, a couple of light. You can really see that multi-tonal color variation in your Mochaccino brown that really helps for it to color correct into your natural hair and blend really seamlessly. Now your Mochaccino brown has more of that golden undertone. However, your next color up is going to be your number 2. Now a number 2 dark brown. Your dark brown is going to be the same depth and the same level, so around a level 5, just like your Mochaccino. However, this has more of a red undertone. So if you look at your hair in the sunlight and you start to see a little bit more of that red tone, the number 2 is going to be right for you, compared to the Mochaccino brown, which again has more of a golden undertone. Now if either one of these just look too warm for your hair, you do have more of an ashier color to your hair, but you're sitting around the same depth and the same level, our walnut brown might be the perfect color for you. Still at that level 5, but it's got more of an ashy tone to it. So if your natural hair doesn't have a lot of warmth, it's more of a darker brown and almost like a dark brown dishwater. That's the way that you would describe your hair. Your walnut brown could be the perfect match for you. Now, chocolate brown is around a level 6 with a lot of red and gold undertones. It's got a lot of warmth to it and it blends really beautifully with people that do have more of a natural to warm color. Again, you're going to see a lot of that multi-tonal effect throughout your chocolate brown. So again, if you think, I'm not sure if it's going to blend perfectly, that multi-tonal color going through your clip-ins is really going to help with it blending. Our next jump is going to be from our chocolate brown and we go up to our chestnut. So chestnut is number 6, and so you can see there's a big variation here. There's a difference. So if your hair is just a little bit lighter, and we're moving more towards that level, like a light level 6, almost a level 7, with a lot of warmth, a lot of gold, but no red. This is gonna be the a great color for you. So if you naturally have really dark hair and maybe you give yourself highlights or you go to a salon to get highlights but you don't want them to be too bright, you don't really like it when your hair looks gray or dull, this could be a great option for you and it could match perfectly. Now from chestnut, we're gonna move on to our almond color. Now almond has a lot more warmth to it, but it's going to be the same exact level as your chestnut brown. So you'll see it's got a lot more warmth and it almost has a red undertone. Golden undertones are a little bit softer, whereas when you see that red undertone, it's just got a little bit more vibrancy. And that's really what your almond brown will have. It's just got a little bit more vibrancy to the hair, but again, still with that multi-tonal effect. Next on the spectrum after almond is going to be our ash brown. Ash brown I use quite a bit and it matches a majority of people's hair. Again, if you think of yourself naturally as that kind of dishwater, a blonde color, it's just kind of right in the middle. You usually like to make it a little darker or make it a little bit lighter. Usually that's where that ash brown will sit. And this is where a lot of people's hair have a tendency to lighten too on the ends. And that's really what you're matching, right? You're not matching what's happening up here. You might be a little bit darker here, but then when your ends lighten up just a bit, that's exactly what this ash brown color will mimic. The next color that we are gonna go over is going to be our dirty blonde. Now the dirty blonde, the best way for me to describe this is it's almost like this perfect beigey tone. And it does sit at around a level 8, almost a level 9 on the spectrum. So it is a little bit lighter, but you'd almost think that it's on the darker side of a blonde. It's a really, really, really light brown, but it's a very, very dark blonde. And it does have that multi-dimensional color to it. And when you think of a beige, and what I think of a beige is it's almost like you'll see a little bit of warmth and you'll see a little bit of cool. So it sits somewhere in a neutral category, but if your hair is naturally has a little bit more warmth, you're gonna see it in the extensions and in this color, and it'll kind of enhance that tone. Now, if you have a little bit more of a cool tone, you'll notice that it enhances more of that cool. So it does have a tendency to blend in really well. From dirty blonde, we're gonna jump directly into strawberry blonde. Now, the difference between strawberry blonde and dirty blonde is number one, the strawberry blonde is just gonna be a little bit lighter. It's not gonna be a full level lighter, but maybe like a half a level. So it's gonna be around that like 8.5 color. And your strawberry blonde, while your dirty blonde has a little bit of that golden hue to it, your strawberry blonde will have a little bit more of like a red hue to it. And the way that it blends is really great. It's not this solid, solid red color. The way that the strawberry blonde has been created is that it is that multi-tonal color that has a little bit of blonde in there, a little bit of red in there, but it's all mixed and blended seamlessly. So if you really have that natural color that's very light and has a little bit of that red tone, strawberry blonde is going to be a great color for you. Now we're going to start moving into our lighter shades, which are a little bit more on the platinum side. And our first color is going to be the butter blonde. Now butter blonde is made up of 3 different colors, and this color blends really well with anyone who's really highlighted their hair. Maybe they've had that, you know, a little bit of a darker color, a little bit darker than dishwater, and you just get highlights. Usually butter blonde is kind of a go-to color, and the way that the placement of the color is in each one of the clip-ins is you can see a little bit more of those variations. So it gives you a little bit more dimension rather than just a seamless blend throughout. This is one that's kind of a go-to for me in my salon as well. I always have it on photo shoots because I know if I have a blonde coming in, this color can really kind of mimic and morph into any blonde that's sitting at that like level 9, almost level 10. So from Butter Blonde, we're gonna jump to our next shade of blonde, which is our Beach Blonde. And I'm gonna pull both out so you can see the comparison. Now this is gonna be our Butter, and this is our Beach. Now our Butter Blonde, remember, it's got a little bit more of that multi-tonal color, and it even has a little bit of depth in there. And it's interesting, if you really look at it, it has like a little bit of the Dirty Blonde color, a little bit of Beach Blonde, so it's really made to sit on the spectrum right between the two. But you can see a little bit more of that high-low effect, which if you get highlights, it's perfect. Now, if your hair is a little bit more solid on the ends, Beach Blonde might be great for you. This is really a color that, when I think of Barbie Blonde, this is the color. It's got a little bit of gold to it. It's got a little bit of warmth to it, but it's, you know, it's a platinum. It's not white blonde. It doesn't have any purple undertones as well. It's just a very natural platinum blonde. Another way that I think of Beach Blonde is if you are kind of that dirty blonde color and you've done a heavy, heavy highlight. Maybe your stylist has toned your hair, and now that maybe that ashy tone or that extra warmth is starting to fade away after a few weeks, that's kind of where this color sits. It's a very neutral platinum blonde. The next tone that we're going to talk about is going to be the platinum blonde. Now, platinum blonde will sit at the same level as your 613, your Beach Blonde. So it's gonna be the same level of brightness. However, what you'll notice is that one looks a little bit more warm than the other one. So if you looked at the Beach Blonde on its own, it's almost like, oh yeah, that's really bright, that's really blonde. But then when you look at the platinum right next to it, you'll see that the platinum has more of a blue or a purple hue undertone, which gives it an icier look. So it's almost like right off of the bat, when you got your hair toned, once you've gotten it done, you can be really close to this platinum color. And platinum, it's a very, very soft amount of that purple or blue undertone. But if you're looking for something with even more of that maybe purple or blue undertone as opposed to the platinum, you might like the Ash Blonde. It has more of those purple and blue undertones, which will match more of those cool tones in your hair. Now finally, if your ash tone is just not ashy enough, you like your hair almost borderline silver. It's got so much blue and so much purple in it that this would almost look yellow against your hair, you might be a sterling silver. This is going to be your sterling silver color, which has a lot of purple, a lot of blue in it, which almost gives it a silver or metallic look to it. So it's almost like that platinum blonde. If you lifted your hair all the way up and then you put a purple or a blue toner on it, you let it sit, even if it's a flash lift toner, it's going to leave more of this color. Our final natural tone is going to be our vibrant red. Now your vibrant red is going to be on your level around a 7 to an 8. And the reason why it's at a 7 or an 8 is because it also has, it's got a little bit of depth, but it's got a little bit of that extra vibrancy to it. And again, when you look at this vibrant color, you're gonna have that multi-tonal effect. So when you piece it apart, you'll see there's a couple of pieces that look a little bit more like a strawberry blonde. There's a couple of pieces that look extra, extra vibrant. And those are all blended together seamlessly. So this color can really blend and match with anybody that's colored their hair to a red tone. The next collection that we're going to go into is going to be our rooted colors. Now, rooted colors are going to be made up of two different tones. One is going to be a darker color right at the base, and it's going to be about 2.5 to 3 inches long, and then it has a quick transition into a lighter tone. So it gives the appearance of almost having a root color or a lived-in color. This is very popular right now. A lot of times, even when we go to our stylist, we'll ask for more of a lived-in color that we can wait a longer period of time before coming into the salon. So this will mimic that same look. The darkest of this color collection is going to be our rooted off black to almond. Now, we had already discussed where we're at with that color almond, so it's a little bit more of a warmer tone right on the ends, and it's a little bit more multi-dimensional, and it almost has like a reddish hue to it as well, so it's very, very warm. And then the top area is going to be a 1B. So you can see it's a quick transition of that dark color into your almond brown. The next color in this collection is going to be the cool brown to butter blonde. So the butter blonde has that multi-dimensional tone. It's got a little bit of that beach blonde color in there, a little bit of the dirty blonde. So you can see it's got a very slight amount of dimension, but you'll see at the top for the first 2.5 to 3 inches, you've got a cool brown color and it's a quick transition. So if you normally get your hair colored and maybe they melt your base down or they give you a shadow root, this could be the same exact look, except for the root will be just a little bit longer than what they would do if they were doing the shadow root on your hair. Now, from butter blonde, from our rooted butter blonde, we're gonna jump into our rooted honey blonde. So our rooted honey blonde has an ash brown base, so it's almost like that level 8, and we've got a honey blonde color on the ends, again with that 2 to 3 inch transition with a quick transition directly into our blonde color. Your honey blonde is a little bit more multi-dimensional, and your honey blonde has it's still considered a platinum blonde, but it's going to be in the neutral family and almost like a beige. It's got great tonality, and again, it's got that multi-dimensional tone, so it can match almost any blonde that's been highlighted. And finally, in our rooted collection, we have got our 360 rooted. Now, our 360 rooted has a walnut brown at the base, and it jumps down into that ashy blonde color on the ends. This is something that I think works really well, especially if you normally get an on-scalp bleach and you're trying to grow it out, or if you usually do a heavy, heavy highlight and now you're trying to transition into something that's a little less maintenance. This is gonna be a great clip-in that you can wear because it's got that deep base, but then it has those bright ends. This color is perfect for quarantine. It's got the darker root, the blonde ends. So if you're struggling with your clip-ins, you normally get platinum, but now we're in lockdown again, your 360 is where you gotta go. Our next color we're gonna go over is going to be our 2-8 ombre. Now, your ombre color is going to be made up of two different colors, a dark and a light, and you'll see that there's a quick transition between the two, almost like the rooted, only the darker color is brought down farther with a quick transition closer to around the mid-shaft area. So if you think, oh, I really want to have an ombre look to my hair, and you naturally have an ombre look to your hair, let's say you're dark here and light here, almost like what my hair looks like, if I tried to put this ombre in, it might not be exactly what I want because the ombre portion and the dark portion come down so far for this gradient that you might want to go with something that's a little bit lighter coming up to the root, like a rooted tone. But if you have darker hair, it's longer, and you wanna add a little bit of brightness without seeing any of the clip directly to your top and to your scalp, your ombre could be a great choice for you. So the next color in our collection is gonna be the warm brown and honey blonde ombre. Now, you can see it is made up of two colors, however, they're very high in contrast. So the warm brown color really has more of a golden tone at the top. It'll sit around that level 6 color, and it drops into that brighter tone just on the ends. And this is definitely warmer than the beach blonde, but not as pink as the Strawberry Blonde. Similar to this ombre and these transitions, our next color is the Ash Brown and Strawberry Blonde. So the Ash Brown and Strawberry Blonde, as you can see, have just a little bit of a softer transition from the dark to the light. And the Strawberry Blonde has that extra bit of warmth on the ends, while that Ash Brown at the top gives almost a cool effect. So you'll notice that this almost plays off of not only the cool tones, but also the warm to sit in a really kind of neutral category. And when I wear clip-ins for myself, this is one of my go-to colors that I use, especially when I haven't gotten my color done in 6 or 8 months. Having that extra depth at the base is really helpful. And what I like to do is I will even kind of dock off this end because it gets a little too bright for me, but I love this transition color. So I'll cut it to here and it gives me a great blend for even my color. This does have kind of a softer transition, even though it's considered an ombre color. This color transition is what you would see in our collection that is considered our balayage. So this is one of our balayage shades. This is going to be the white mocha balayage. It's got a cool base right at the top that's going to be around, just a little bit lighter than the walnut brown. You'll see there's a 50-50 blend right in the middle. And then at the very ends, you've got that ash blonde or almost platinum color that gives the entire set of clip-ins a very, very cool effect. So if you normally ask your colorist to please keep my hair as cool and icy as possible, you naturally have a more of an ashy tone to your hair and you like that whiter blonde on the ends, this is gonna be a great color for you. Now, when we created this white mocha color, we thought, how cool can we get this? How platinum can we get the ends? And how can we really play off of these extra icy tones? And we thought, what would be really fun is having almost an opposite of that color. And that is where we created this beautiful Golden Hour Blonde Balayage. So just as we discussed the idea of how cool that white mocha is, your Golden Hour is going to play so much more off of those warmer tones. The base of this balayage color is going to be almost close to your ash brown color, but with an extra kick of a golden color. And then it slowly transitions again with that 50-50 blend right in the middle of the light and the dark color together to end up nice and blonde on the ends. Honestly, this is really good for somebody who is a really, really light, almost like a light golden color naturally. And you know, your ends kick out to this really, really bright golden color, especially when you're out in the sun. This is gonna be the perfect color for you. Our next collection of transitional shades that we're gonna go into is going to be our highlighted colors. Now, when you think of Bellamy highlights, think of high contrast colors, a high and a low, so a bright and a dark, and they're placed right next to each other. So it's not a seamless blend. You can actually see more dimension in the two or three colors that's on the actual clip-in itself. So our first color is going to be the Ash Blonde. And as you can see, you've got a lot of high, a lot of low. So this has three different colors that make up this clip-in color. And what's great is that you can see the blonde, you can see the dark, and when you see it on the ends, it gives you that heavy contrast, that heavy dimension, which looks very natural, especially when you go and get your highlights done. And if you go in and you usually get maybe highlights and lowlights to keep dimension in, this could be a great option for you. So if we're looking at this and we're thinking, love the light, love the dark, I definitely go in and I get my highlights done, I get my lowlights done to make sure I have dimension every single time I get my hair colored. If we look at this kind of ash blonde color and we think, oh man, it might be a little bit too dark, and you do veer more towards the blonde side, that is where our next highlight color will come into play. This is going to be the Honeycomb Highlight. And so you can see the difference in transition. There's way more of the lighter tones than there is the dark. And that's why it'll still give you a beautiful contrast and a beautiful dimension, but it's a little bit more muted, and it will definitely mimic more of a blonde as opposed to that highlighted blonde and brown tone. Now, if you love the color of this honeycomb highlight, however you think maybe I want it to look just a little bit more ashy, or maybe just if it wasn't so blonde all the way to the top, because you wait a little bit longer between your color services, you might be the perfect candidate for our pearl blonde highlight. So this is our honeycomb, which is a little bit warmer. And then on the opposite side, we have our pearl blonde highlight. So this will veer way more towards a cooler and ashier side. And you'll see you've got your pops of blonde and you've got a little bit of depth in there as well for that extra bit of dimension. But even when you look at the dimension that we've created in these clip-ins, it's an ashier color. And that ashier color is really kind of right near our ash brown. So it's around that level 7, level 8 color. But it's got a lot more of that cool blue tonality to even the low lights. And that low light color that is transitioning all throughout the clip-ins at the bottom is actually what is a root at the top. So if you have that light ashy brown color naturally, this root is going to match you perfectly. One more thing. Now, with the pearl blonde highlight color, this color is so beautiful, and it's very much so on that ashier, icier side. So this is great for when you just get your hair colored. And if you do a shadow root or you naturally have that kind of ashier tone, this is gonna be perfect for you while you still have that beautiful tone that your stylist put in. Moving on from our highlighted collection directly into our marble blends. Now, our Bellamy marble blend colors are made up of either 2 to 3 different shades that are evenly blended throughout the entire clip-in to give you a very seamless color, but again, very multi-dimensional, but just not a heavy contrast. So the first color out of this group is gonna be your bronzed caramel marble blend. And this is one of my favorite colors out of our entire collection, and it's because it really does match a majority of my clients' hair, especially after about 6 weeks. So when my clients come back to me in 6 weeks, this is like that color that matches their hair perfectly. Me personally, if you were looking at my hair and maybe my hair is very close to what you look like, I would think this is where I go to look a little bit darker, maybe my fall vibes, and then this is my bright summer look. This is a great marble blend. It does have additional depth at the top. We've got that heavy variance right in the middle, and then we've got that nice pop of blonde right on the ends. Even though it is a marble blend, we were able to create almost like a balayaged effect with a marble blend all in one set of clip-ins, which really gives it so much more diversity, and it can really fit in with your blonde hair. Our next color out of our marble blends is going to be the caramel marble blend. And this color was inspired by our professional color, which is the caramel blonde. That color was such a hit and is used so much that we decided to make a mate on the clip-in side. It has a tendency to really blend with the majority of people's color. A lot of times I've noticed, especially on the ends, if you are maybe like a brown, just a normal run-of-the-mill level 5 brown, and you lighten your hair by highlighting it, that is what this blended color will look like in your hair. That will match your ends perfectly. This color does have multi-dimensional and multi-tonal colors, so when it sits in your hair, if you naturally have a warmer color in your hair, you'll see a little bit more warmth in here. If your hair borders more of that neutral side, it will pick up more of those neutral tones. So it can't, it's almost like a chameleon. It can kind of blend into anything and fit in any category, as long as the level is correct. So if you sit around that kind of level 8, maybe a level, you're right in between, you're like a light level 8, like the ash brown. If you used a natural ash brown from our collection and it's just a little too dark, this could be the perfect color for you. Now, moving from our caramel marble blend, we're going to move directly into our ash bronze marble blend. Now, these look really similar. However, when you put them side by side, and remember, we're kind of thinking like, what's the other's mate? If you look at these side by side, your ash bronze has a little bit of lighter blonde and lighter strokes in there. And it's, so it gives it just a little bit more of an ashier effect. Whereas your caramel blonde is kind of that neutral. Like I said, it can pivot from one to the other, but your ash bronze really has more of that extra bit of coolness to it. They still sit on the same area, on the same level. So if your natural hair, if you look at the ash brown, for example, on our natural tones and you think, oh my gosh, I love this color, but I just need it a little bit lighter and I really need it just a bit ashier. It almost looks a little too warm in my hair. This ash blonde marble blend could be perfect for you. Our next collection is a collaboration with the balayage guru himself, Guy Tang. And we've got 7 different shades that make up this collection and we're gonna break them down. Our first color, it is our 1C, so a mochaccino, down to the chocolate brown. The 1C4 is a great color because it's extremely subtle. The people that I can see this matches the best with are people that this is their natural color. They naturally have this beautiful kind of, golden tone that all of a sudden, when the sun hits it just a little bit, you'll see the ends get a bit brighter. And that's exactly what this soft, subtle transition is. It's just a little bit of a sun-kissed finish just on the very ends. Now, if you're looking for something with just a little bit more pop, you love this look, but you're looking for just a little bit more of that extra bit on the ends that'll be a little bit brighter, that's when you can move into your 2-6, which is a dark brown to chestnut brown. So you can see when they're side by side, although they both are sitting in a darker shade and in a darker level, one has way more of that bright tone just on the ends. So that's gonna be our 2-6 balayage, which is the dark brown to chestnut brown, versus the 1C4. Your 1C4 is gonna be a lot more subtle than your 2-6 balayage. The people that I've noticed that my dark brown, chestnut brown works really well for is my clients that come in and get highlights, and then we tone them down to make it very subtle. And then after 6 weeks or so, their toner starts to fade and you'll see what almost looks like what they'd consider brassy. And that's kind of where my dark brown, chestnut brown sits, and it blends perfectly. It has just a little bit of gold to it and it blends seamlessly in with those clients. Now, if you love the look of this transition between the dark brown to the chestnut brown, but maybe you're looking for something that's a little bit more of a statement, it's a bit brighter, and you really want to have that extra pop on the ends, our next step up would be the 1C, which is the mochaccino, down to dirty blonde. So the 1C has that darker base, but more of that neutral golden tone. And it has a very nice transition at about mid-shaft, which is a 50-50 blend between your dirty blonde as well as your mochaccino. And it comes all the way down to those bright dirty blonde ends. Maybe this mochaccino is just a little off. Your natural hair has a little bit more of a red hue to it, but you love this look. Then I would suggest to go for your next color, which is going to be the dark brown to dirty blonde. So you can see it's still gonna be in that darker brown family, in that level 5 tone, but it's got a little bit of a richer hue at the top, and it goes down with that 50-50 transitional blend, mid-shaft, down to those bright dirty blonde ends. But maybe your natural hair isn't as dark as a dark brown, and maybe it's not as dark as a mochaccino brown. You love the look of those dirty blonde ends with the balayage, but you need something just a little brighter at the top. Then the next shade of chocolate brown to dirty blonde would work perfectly for you. We've got that same chocolate brown color at the top. We've got our transitional tones of the dirty blonde with the chocolate brown in the middle, and then kicks out to that bright dirty blonde on the ends. As we move higher on the color spectrum for this collection, we are going to get into our next color, which is going to be the cool brown to dirty blonde. So this is a great choice if we are looking, let's say for example, at our step below, which is gonna be the chocolate brown to dirty blonde, and we think we love this color, but my natural color at the top is just too light. This dark tone would peek through and it would look unnatural. Our cool brown to dirty blonde could be a great option for you. And as you can see, we still follow through with those same transitions. We start off with kind of at that level 7 color at the top, with our transition right in the middle of our 50-50 blend down to our bright dirty blonde ends. Now, our final color out of this collection is going to be the 860. And now this color is one of my favorite colors to work with. It is the ash brown to ash blonde. It's fantastic for anybody who is that balayaged blonde. Maybe they start off, you start off at that brown color, maybe that dishwater brown, that level 7 at the top, and you either balayage your ends, or even if you do a highlight and you do a smudge root or a shadow root or even a melt, this color will be fantastic for you. With the same transitions, we've got that level 8 color at the top, a 50-50 blend of the color 8 and the color 60 in the middle, in mid shaft, and then finally that extra blonde ash at the very ends. We are going to make our way from one collection to the other. We've got our balayage guru making our way to our platinum king himself, Zach Mesquite's collaboration with Bellamy Hair. We've got 8 different colors in this line, and they are all stunning. The first color that we are going to start with, and they all have amazing names. The first color that we are going to start off with is Bougie. Now, Bougie is a beautiful, beautiful platinum color, but it sits at a perfectly neutral tone. There's no gold, but it's creamy. It's a very creamy platinum color. With your Bougie color, there's no additional hue of gold. There's no additional hue of ash. It sits perfectly at that neutral state. Now, if you love this Bougie color, but you're thinking, oof, I love it, but I have just a little bit of a root to my hair, and I'd like to give that same look with my extensions, that is where Tan Lines comes in. So you can see the color is almost similar, but your tan lines will have just a little bit more of an icier tone. I don't wanna say it's ashy, but it does sit a little bit more on the icier side. And it has a beautiful root. Now this root is gonna be about 2 inches long, and even the root tone is around a level 8, but nice and ashy. It's neutral to ash for the root down to this beautiful platinum beige. That's exactly how I would categorize this color. It's a platinum beige, and it's like a very, very high lift color. Very soft, but definitely a statement. Now our next color, if we're looking at this and we're thinking, oh my gosh, I love this color, but I definitely have more of a violet hue to my hair. Maybe you go and get a on scalp bleach and you always tell them you wanna have more of an icy color. It's not blue, but it's a purple. It's like a purple undertone. This is the diamond color by Zach Mesquite, and you can see it's extremely icy with a purple undertone. When we think of platinums and we think of toners, we always kind of veer more towards a purple or a blue. And as we make our way through the Zach Mesquite collection, you will notice that as the colors get a little bit darker, you'll notice that it takes on less of a violet hue and more of a blue undertone. And that's really what gives it almost like a deeper and icier look. Moving from diamonds, that would bring us directly into Iris. You can see it looks just a little bit deeper, and that's because it is starting to add not just purple, but a little bit of blue, a little bit of purple, and this really does give more of a platinum effect, but just a little bit muted. It's a little bit softer and not so visually white, white, blonde. So our next step into our bluer tones will be goals. Now goals is a great color because again, this one is one of the, there's only a couple of colors in this line that have a rooted base, and this is gonna be one of them. It's got that deeper level 7 now because we're getting a little bit more blue. Anytime you add ash, cool tones, purple tones, you'll notice that it brings, it almost makes it look like the level is a little bit darker. And so even though this looks like it might be a level 7, it's probably around an ashy 8 at the top. And you'll see as we kind of pull it apart, it's a very, very platinum white color with a blue undertone. Now, if we're looking at this color and we're thinking, I love this, but my hair has even more blue undertone to it. Like this would almost look white blonde next to your more blue hued undertoned hair, then I would, then I would suggest to go into rolls. Rolls is great. It isn't rooted, but it does have that extra blue, extra purple undertone for that platinum hair. And if you're looking for something that's even more of a statement, maybe you're thinking, I love this color, but I want it to be even more vibrant. I'd like to bring out that extra blue, that extra purple. You might even just want to add it in as color in your hair. I would highly suggest to go with something like Limo Tint. So Limo Tint is going to be borderline silver. It's got so much blue and so much purple as its undertones, but it's kind of nice because it has a root to it as well. But this root has been dragged down a little bit farther. It's probably about 4 inches down. This is a great color that you can utilize if you actually have darker hair and you're looking for pops of color. You want to add brightness, but you don't want to see this color directly up to your scalp. Limo Tint can be an awesome color for you. So there you have it. That was our extensive breakdown of all of the shades that we offer here at Bellamy, not only our collection, but also our collaborations as well. Now, if you have any other questions, feel free to watch part 1 and part 2 of these videos, which do include going over how to match what color is going to work for you and also the different technologies that we offer. If you liked this video and you found it helpful, go ahead and hit the subscribe button below and leave us a comment, and we will see you next time.